The more you use a list, the more it fills up. Eventually, you might have pages of information. So how do you find what you're looking for when that happens? Well, if you know what you're looking for, you can search for it. Another way to find stuff is to use the column headings to sort and filter the list. This list is in alphabetical order by last name, but you can change that by clicking the arrow that appears when you point to the heading and choosing another option. Or you can sort by a different column, such as first name. But let's say I remember a guy whose name starts with an M, and I think I know who he works for, but I'm not sure. I can filter the list by first names that start with an M, and add a second filter if that helps. To clear a filter, I just point to the column heading, click the arrow, and clear the filter. Sorting and filtering a list in this way isn't permanent. In other words, if I leave the page and come back, I have to start sorting and filtering all over again. But if I do some sorting and filtering and then decide I want to save it, I can save it as a view. I'll give my view a name and then decide whether I want to make it personal or keep it public. Depending on my permissions, I may not have an option. I'll keep this one personal and save it. Now my saved view appears just above the list, and I have a new way to find information anytime I come back here. To see another view, I just click it. Let's try this with the task list. There are a few views to choose from, and more views hidden under the ellipses. The views are a powerful way to organize information that we'll explore in related videos.